today we are going to discuss about equality of matrices and addition and subtraction and multiplication by a scalar of matrices. Let's start by equality of matrices. In previous video, we discussed what is a matrix, how to represent a matrix, and types of matrices. Today, let's continue that by equality first. Let's start equality of matrices. Okay, let there be two matrices. A is equal to Aij, m by n, and B is equal to Bij, r by s. Okay, we discussed in previous video how to represent a matrix in a single form. Means, we will take any representation of the element, means Aij, where I is the number or which row the element is present in. I is which row the element is present in, and J is which column the element is present in. And here M by N means here M is the total number of rows, or it is the maximum value of I. N is total number of columns, or it is the maximum number of J. I and J varies from 1 to M and N respectively. And the conditions for these two matrices being equal is, first, M is equal to R. If you observe carefully, M is number of rows in the matrix A and R is number of rows in the matrix B. Both of those should be equal, means number of rows in both of the matrices should be equal. And N is equal to S. N is number of columns in first matrix and S is number of columns in second matrix. So, the columns in both the matrix also should be equal. And the last is Aij is equal to Bij for all 1 less than I less than M and comma 1 less than J less than N. Okay, it should be less than or equal to. It means that the values of I vary from 1 to M and the values of J vary from 1 to N. Right? Then it is written as A by B. Else if any of these conditions is not equal, then we should write that A is not equal to B in normal representations. Now let's see addition of matrices. If A comma B are two matrices with same order, their order should be same. We discussed it, right? M by N and R by S. But here it should have same order. For equality of matrices also, it should have same order. Should have same order M by N. Then their addition is the sum of corresponding elements. Means in the first matrix, if we take the element in first row and second column, and you should add that with the element in first row and second column of the second matrix, means same row and same column. Means if two matrices are Aij m by n and Bij m by n, then A plus Bij means the element in the ith row and jth column of the matrix A plus B is Aij plus Bij. Means the element in ith row and jth column in the A, in the matrix A, and the element in ith row and jth column in the matrix B. For all 1 less than or equal to I less than or equal to M, and 1 less than or equal to J less than or equal to N. Means I should have values between 1 and M, J should have values between 1 and N. And its properties are, it is commutative, means A plus B is equal to B plus A. It is associative, means A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. And null matrix is identity element for it. Means if we add null matrix for any matrix, then the matrix does not change. Its identity does not change. Means A plus 0 is equal to 0 plus A is equal to A, where 0 means it denotes the 0 matrix or null matrix. And For any matrix A, there exists a additive inverse. There exists an additive inverse such that the sum of both of those matrices is 0. Means A plus, the additive inverse is minus A. A plus minus A is equal to 0 is equal to minus A plus A. And cancellation works. Means if you take A plus B is equal to A plus C, then you can cancel out S and you can write like B is equal to C. Okay, why they have mentioned cancellation works? It will not work for all S. It will not work for all the concepts in mathematics. For some concepts, cancellation will not work. Multiplication by a scalar. Multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. If A is equal to Aij m by n, means there is a matrix A which is denoted by Aij m by n with m rows and n columns, then K into A, any scalar K into A is equal to K into Aij m by n, right? That means K into A is equal to K into Aij m by n. Means we should multiply with K for every element where K is a scalar. And K is a scalar or constant. And the properties of multiplication by a scalar are K into A plus B is equal to KA plus KB. K into a matrix A plus B is equal to K into A plus K into B. Means distribution law works. And K plus L into A is equal to K into A plus L into A, where K and L are two constants or scalars. And K into L A is equal to K into L times A plus L into K times A. Means associative law works. And minus K into A is equal to minus K A is equal to K into minus A. And the important note is that if you want to subtract two matrices, means if you want to do A minus B, you can write that like A plus minus B, or it is A plus minus 1 into B. Means you should multiply the element B with a scalar negative 1, and you should add A and that resultant matrix, and you will get the subtraction of those both matrices. Okay guys, this is for today. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're not, comment down below why you haven't. If you have any doubts, comment down below. I'll answer them in the next video.